Welcome, 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 you guys. It is your girl, Brown Skin Exoticals, and I am back with another video for you guys. Y'all see the pun, so y'all already know this is gonna be a good one. Today we're gonna talk about the identity policing that happens to us mixed and light skin, as well as us exotical people. And I'm gonna point out some of the hypocrisies and hopefully give y'all some practical advice. Let's get into it. So whether it's family members, friends, strangers, random people on the internet, you will always have someone trying to tell you who you are as an exotical. You're too light-skinned to be black. You're too dark-skinned to be mixed. It doesn't matter. No one's ever satisfied enough. We can't let people gatekeep our identities as exoticals, and we can't let other exoticals tell us who we are. Whether someone wants to identify as light skin, yellow bone, mulatto, mix, black, doesn't matter. We as exoticals gotta respect each other and how we identify. And we all gotta make sure we're setting a good example for the younger generation of exoticals. Because just like us, the world doesn't wait until you're 18 to start bullying and harassing you. This little girl was 7 years old when a grown woman cut her hair twice. And we gotta make sure that our kids know, hey, the world is literally out to get you. And it's sad, but that's just the price you have to pay for being an exotical. And the funny thing about Blackistan and dark-skinned black women in particular is they will act like exotical beauty counts as black beauty. It's not. It's two different things. Most of the quote black beauty you see in the black community are exoticals or foreign black women. I said what I said. We got to be selfish with our image, and we got to say, no, that is an exotical. No, that is a biracial woman. No, that is a multi-generationally mixed woman. We got to start claiming our own and shoving it down their throats until it clicks. We are mixed. We are the exoticals. You can't kick us in and out of the black community anymore. Because when we were in the black community, they like to play this game with us where they want to point out all our black features and tell us where we belong. And, oh, this is how society sees you. And perception is reality and all this other bullshit. Nobody gets to tell me who I am. And some of them will say, oh, well, when the cops see you, they see a black person. Or what's on your license and registration? Does it say mix? Mix is not a race. They can't tell us who we are. If you're a light-skinned black woman with type 4 hair or a biracial woman with type 4 hair, they will clown you for it. And, oh, see, you got nappy hair. See, you a waste of light skin. All these horrible things that you could never say to a dark skin with type 4 hair, mind you. And on the flip side, us darker skin and brown skin exoticals with type 3 hair, oh, is it a wig? Is it a weave? Are you part Indian? What are you? What are you? What are you? The harassment never stops, you guys. They are so obsessed with us exoticals to the point now they have this thing where they get these tattoo baby hairs and edges because they want to look like us. I don't know how else to say it, you guys. We got to wake up and realize we will do nothing but be exotical and be special and unique and different. And they hate it. No one hates being black more than a dark-skinned black woman. I said what I said. Nobody hates being black more than a dark-skinned black woman. And even our exotical kings, if you think, oh, well, I'm dark-skinned, so I fit as black. No, you don't, babe. They're still going to come for you, too. So you might as well realize, all of us have to realize, we exoticals gotta stay together regardless of the situation. Because it's funny when you see these light-skinned black women being portrayed as the love interest, or you see these exoticals being portrayed as the love interest, then we're light-skinned, featureist, texturist, benefiting from all these isms. But when it comes to the cops, we're black. So you see how they want to tell us our racial identity and change their minds, but when we take control of our own identities, they get upset? It's because these women are jealous, and jealous women don't make sense. Jealous people don't make sense. Let's be honest. These are the type of dark-skinned black women who will point at the lightest and brightest part of their wrists and say, ooh, look at me, team light skin, team brown skin. I ain't no darky. I ain't black. I ain't that dark. I'm mixed with da-da-da-da-da. They want to be exoticals, you guys, and we won't let them. It is not our fault that dark-skinned black women learned how to put in a wig and weave in their hair before they learned how to love themselves. Exoticals, we got to be proud of who we are and let them hear it and keep saying it until they realize we're going to keep living our lives like it's golden, because it is. Let your beautiful skin shine, smile, and always stay golden and stay exotical. Thank you.